Hey guys, this is Deepika here and welcome back to my channel. This is part 2 of our day 1 in Hampi. If you haven't watched the first part, I will leave the details in the description box below and also in the end screen of this particular video. You can click to watch the same. So let's get started with the vlog.
Not many a times they were allowed to go outside, for recreational activities. So most of the palaces have a recreational ground like this. So this is called the Lotus Palace because of the structure it was built. This actually has a lotus structure. It looks like a blossoming lotus jar. So that is the reason this place was called as Lotus Mahal. So this is actually right opposite to the ladies' palace. Not exactly a palace, a place to stay. So if you see the screen right now, that is the place you actually have the women of the royal family staying, from where they will reach this place for recreational activities with your friends and dasis or servants for that matter. So guys, I was also informed that this particular palace that you see is also not just the recreational place for the queens. It was also a sea place, like a leisure place here. So if you see on top of this particular place, you have a few rooms that has been built. Right now they do not allow us to go inside the place because of some reason I am not too aware of, but yes, this was a place where this was also called a summer palace is what I was informed, and they used to come to this place because it is made of limestone, and most of this place would be cool during summers, and the summer heat here in the Vijayanagar Empire was absolutely ruthless. It used to be very hot. So they used to come to this place, which is completely built of limestone, and the king and the queen would stay here. Apart from the king, no one else was allowed here, as this is a dedicated place for the queens to stay. So this is the view of the palace from another angle, and here I see that there is a well. And I guess that's a watchtower behind there, where soldiers would be standing to see if there is any kind of an attack that happens on the place.
This is the elephant stable within the Zenana enclosure here in Hampi. It is said that each of these rooms here were used to keep the elephants, feed them, and also a place for them to rest. This place can be found right behind the Lotus Mahal, and you will have to be purchasing a ticket in order to enter the Zenana enclosure. So in case you buy a ticket here, you would be able to visit the Zenana enclosure and another place here, the Vijaya Vitala temple, on the same day. So just in case you are visiting Hampi, do plan your day accordingly so that you would be able to visit two places with the same ticket. outside the Zenana enclosure, a little away, you can visit the Archaeological Museum in Hampi. This archaeological museum houses a variety of sculptures and ruins from the Vijayanagar Empire. It preserves the relic and artifacts found in and around the place, which was once a prosperous and a wealthy kingdom. The details about the entry fee, timing, and the other information is provided in the description box below.
Guys, we have reached the Hazare Rama temple here, and this particular temple has a speciality of thousand sculptures around the temple from the sacred book of Ramayana. So it is said that each picture here around the temple depicts a story from Ramayana, and collectively has about 1,000 pictures that are actually sculpted around the temple.
This is said to be the Pan Bazaar or the betel leaf market of Hampi, which is right outside the Hazare Rama temple.
Actually, this is a central place which has three different places all in the same vicinity. So here, if you see behind me, this is actually the place where the king used to conduct his darbar, where he used to meet his people, give just in case there's some problem, he would solve all the problem here in this place. And somewhere inside, it seems there is a secret chamber where the king used to, plan some secret machine just in case, there is a war or anything as such. So apart from that, there is a place called Dasara Dibba, which actually is a step sort of a tank. So we would be visiting these three places here. So let's go explore this place, guys. So this is a secret chamber from where the king used to plan some secret mission. So just in case they want to, in case there is some kind of a war, or in case they want to attack some other kingdom, so they would be coming to this place in order to plan their plan of action. Thank you.
do apologize for the incorrect mention of the next place, the Dasara Dibba. This particular place that I would be showing you next is the Pushkarni or the step tank. Unfortunately, I was misinformed that this was the Dasara Dibba, because of which I had informed you that this particular information is for the Dasara Dibba.
So guys, we have finally reached the Dasara Dibba. So you can see behind me, this is the place. I was informed that various activities during the festival and different fests that was conducted used to happen here. So in case that the name Dasara Dibba basically suggests that it seems before Mysore, the actual festival of Dasara in Karnataka was held here in Hampi, but after the kingdom here was ruined, and since the king of Mysore is still alive, as in like the Wadayar kingdom is still does have a hereditary that's still ongoing, they actually have got reshifted to Mysore is what I was informed. So I'm not sure of how far this is true, but yes, this is actually the Dasara Dibba and it looks really beautiful.
This is the Dasara Dibba or Mahanavami Dibba. It is said to have been built by Krishnadevaraya after his victory with the Orissa king. The high platform was used during the Dasara festival or any other procession that happened in the city, where the king would sit atop of the platform along with his family and other fellow kings who had visited him.
So guys, we finally reached Queen's Bath, which is another monument here, and this is the final destination, and I would be visiting other places tomorrow. I guess I've exerted myself enough. So this particular place is actually a sort of a swimming pool that was actually built for the royal women. So I will show you how it looks. So this place behind me, and this particular place, here you go. Yeah. So this is the place that was used by the royal women for your spa and swimming activities. So basically the queen from the Lotus Mahal would walk, or rather come to the queen's bath. Queen in those days actually were restricted from traveling around or moving in or seeing common people, so they had a separate place to stay, and they were having different recreational centers where they could go and entertain themselves. So in such a way, here in the Vijayanagara kingdom, it used to be the Lotus Mahal for the queen to stay and for recreational activities, and this place that is the queen's bath for their swimming and bathing activities. So even this is actually a sort of a spa place where the queen used to get their servants, have a nice massage, have the day at leisure, have the swimming activities completed, and go back to the Lotus Mahal from here.
Just before reaching the homestay, we dropped by at the Saswe Kal Ganesha temple, close to the Hemakuta hill or the viewpoint here in Hampi. We were informed that this particular temple was built by one of the merchants who had visited Hampi for business. He traded mustard seeds, that Saswe Kalu in Kannada. It is said that he had received an enormous profit after the business, and as a mark of thanksgiving and respect to the king and as a tribute to the king who was ruling here, he had built this particular temple in the year 1506.
So guys, this is the end of today's vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I would be updating the Virupaksha temple, Vitala temple and the few other sightseeing places tomorrow. I'm not too sure if I would be able to update the video exactly the next day after I update this video, but day 2 would be Vitala temple, Virupaksha temple, and I guess Anjanadri Betta is what I was told. So I will take you along for that also. So stay tuned for more videos. If you like the content, do give it a thumbs up, share the video and subscribe to my channel. And also follow me on my Instagram ID, Deepika's Travel Diaries. Until next time, stay tuned, stay safe.